was this expected? I mean, we knew there was a power struggle, and is it a good move or a bad move for the bank's shareholders, which had recently come out in support of Tidjane Thiam?
Good morning. It was unexpected to us. Tidjane has done a fantastic job over the last few years restructuring the operation. We have been underweight the stock, though, because there has been a lot of internal and external tension around this. But ultimately, the CEO and the chairman's job is to protect the franchise. To us, the reason for the underperform rating has been the fact that their revenues are declining in investment banking and APAC, while their capital consumption is rising. And that, together with their exposures in U.S. high yield and Asian corporate credit, makes them quite vulnerable if there is any hiccup in the macroeconomic environment. I think the new CEO is a safe pair of hands. And what we will be looking in the coming weeks and the coming quarters is whether that push into Asia and into investment banking and that negative jaw between revenues and capital consumption can be addressed.
George, we'll come back to the earnings story and look ahead, because we're going to hear more about that next week in just a moment. Elisa, bring you into the conversation. This does seem to be a bit of a surprise. Certainly the market reacting as if this is a surprise. But I guess something had to happen, because we've been reporting for a long time about the head-to-head that was going on between the CEO and the chairman.
Absolutely, and that very sort of unusually public spat between the investors on the one hand backing the CEO and the chairman on the other hand, had to have some kind of resolution, be it, backing TM or what we're seeing today, the ouster. But it is a little bit messy if you think about what happens next. Yes, you've addressed part of the concerns, you've addressed potentially the image of the bank. But yes, there has been this rupture with shareholders, key shareholders. How do you rebuild that? Is there more management upheaval with this abrupt departure? Again, this will play out over the coming weeks and months. And you have the chairman, who has confirmed he's going to be stepping down in April 2021. So again, more change at the top. So quite a lot of work still to do to rebuild, to strengthen the franchise.
Is that a concern, George? I mean, do you expect more of a management upheaval? As Elisa points out, we do know that that Urs Rohner is going to be stepping down in just about a year and change. Is that a problem for shareholders, this much change?
We think that any tension and any restructuring is an issue at the time was so many moving parts. You have a U.S. election, you have Asian issues, and therefore this is not helpful at all, especially now that UBS, with the hire that they have done, are going to be competing with a very similar strategy to Credit Suisse in the coming years with a clean capital book.
George, is this a Swiss take back control movement here, action that we're seeing? I mean, it's clearly started with very specific roots, but do you think that is also what's going on? So this is a bank that's been run by a sort of international banking elite for many years, isn't it?
I think by now they try to present themselves as quite international, and that will continue. I think the person that took over is the best they had on the bench they had, and he has proven himself on the Swiss Universal Bank, managing all divisions, and he's probably the only one that can continue delivering on the strategy the chairman said, which was the link between investment banking and wealth management.
So, Elisa, is that the right move to start giving shareholders more return? I mean, the stock just hasn't done very well, and they need to do something in order to boost the return to shareholders.
Absolutely. I mean, clearly the scandal that started breaking out in September coincided with a period during which the stock should really have been benefiting from the fruits of the restructuring. So to that end, yes, I think Thomas Gottstein has proven that he's run the Swiss bank, the Swiss unit very well, successfully grown that unit profit. So I think in terms of being the right person for that job, yes, it would appear they've chosen a safe pair of hands.